Good afternoon, Srijita. Today we will discuss about the biodiversity. Biodiversity and conservation. You know that biodiversity, that is the diversity of the living organism. Diversity means there are so many animals, plants, the living organisms are present on our earth. So this type of diversity, the life that exists on the earth, and how could you, how should and why and how you conserve that materials. So this is known as the biodiversity. Okay, Imtiaz and Srijita is present. So in an alien from a distant galaxy had to visit our planet Earth, the first thing that would amaze and baffle him would most probably be the enormous diversity life that he would encounter. Alien means that is a foreigner, that coming from the other planets. And that probably diversity, rich variety of the living organism with which they share this planet never cease to astonish or fascinate us. So we human and the present on the earth, if there is some aliens is coming, they also give them some places to stay there. So thus in this way, the other animals coming from the another parts, the other things coming from the another part, they collectively form the different types of the animals, plants in a particular area and form a biodiversity, okay? The common man would be it hard to believe that there are more than 2,000 species of ants, 3 lakh species of beetles and 28,000 species of fishes and nearly 20,000 species of orchids. So different types of the species means same animals but different types, okay? So 20,000 ants variety, 20,000 beetles, that is small insects that present in different type of flower, the paddy fields, they are also 3 lakhs in varieties, okay? So many diversity you can see in the small group of animals. Ecologists and evolutionary biologists have been trying to understand that significance as diversity by asking important questions. Why are there so many species? Did such great diversity exist throughout Earth history? Or how and why this diversity important to the biosphere? Would it function any differently if the diversity was much less? Actually, what is the effect and what is the role of the biodiversity in the environment? It is, if it is present on our earth, it is useful to our earth, and how they helpful to our earth? Because so many animals present in a diversity, they maintain a cycle or chain. If anyone is deleted from that chain, so total chain system will, ecosystem chain system will be destroyed, okay? So obviously they have so many contribution to our earth, to existence of the different types of the animals, plants. Always, if any animals coming out from the chain system, another animal started to crowd it, okay, they covered the another area, okay? So biodiversity in our biosphere means the place of a earth where living organism exists, that is called biosphere. That is, diversity for heterogeneity exists not only the species level but at the level of the biological organization, ranging from macromolecules within the cell of the biomass. Biodiversity is the term popularized by the sociologist Edward Wilson to describe combined diversity at all levels of the biological organization. Okay, so what is biodiversity? Combined diversity, not only one species present, different species present. Man, tiger, lion, birds, animals, plants, everything. So combined diversity at all the levels of biological organization, that is in our earth, okay? Genetic, the most important for them, genetic diversity. How genetically diversity occurs? A single species, mice, a species that mix with the another species, so they form a new generation with the new species. So genetical variation, obviously some new genes that comes from the another animals. A single species might show how diversity the genetic level over its distributional range. The genetic verification shown by the medicine plant Rauwolfia vormicea growing in the different Himalayan ranges might be in the term of the potency and concentration of active chemical that plant produce. India has 50,000 genetically different strains of rice and 1 lakh varieties of the mango. Okay? So different types of the animals, Rahul, Fia, that can also produce in the Himalayan region for the diversity of the genetics. In India, different types of paddy you can see. So genetical diversity, due to the genetical diversity, you can see the different types of the characteristics in the same type of the animals or plants. Next, species diversity. The diversity of species level, for example, the western ghats have a greater amphibian species diversity than the eastern ghats. So in western ghats, amphibians are present. Frog, different types of frogs you can see in the western ghats. Okay. Ecological diversity. At the ecosystem level, India, for instance, its desert, rainforest, mangroves, and coral reef, wetland, estuaries, and alpine meadows has the greater ecosystem diversity in the Sanchivian country like Norway. So in a country, you can see the difference in the diversity, in the difference in the environment, ecosystem. Lagoons also present, sea also present. Mountain also present, so different types of weathers also present in our India. You can see everything, okay? So this is the ecological diversity. It has millions of years of the evolution to accumulate this rich diversity in nature, but we could lose all this health in the less than 2 centuries if it present rates of the species losses continue. Biodiversity and its conservation now vital environmental issue of international conservation, and more people around the world begin to realize the critical importance of the diversity for our survival and well-being of the planet. Obviously, we should need to protect that diversity for ourselves, okay, not for the environment. If environment is not proper, so how could you survive? So that's why we should obviously conserve our biodiversity. How many species are there on the earth and how many in India? That is not possible to count each and every species that present on the earth and in India. You can see the different groups, mango, you can know that different types of groups are present. So millions, trillions over the man, human, animals and plants are present on the earth. It is not possible to count each and every correctly. Since there are published records of all species discovered and named, we know how many species in all have been recorded so far, but it is not easy to answer the question of how many species there are on the earth. According to the IUCN, the total number of plants and animals discovered is slightly more than 1.5 million. So 1.5 million plants and animals are present on the earth almost, but we have no clear idea how many species are yet to be discovered and described. Estimate vary widely and many of them are only educated guesses. For many taxonomic groups, species inventories are more complete in temperate than in the tropical countries. Considering that in the overwhelmingly large proportion of the species waiting to be discovered in the tropics, biologists make a statistical comparison of the temperate tropical species, reaches an exclusively studied group of insects, and explored the ratio of other groups and animals and plants to come up with the gross estimate of the So some extreme estimate range from 20 to 50 million, but a more conservative and scientifically sound estimate, Robert May, place the global species diversity about 7 million. Okay, so that is different according to the different person, scientist, who are now some of them 1.5 million, some of them call 20 to 50 million. Robert Weston, they almost, that is most popular, is 7 million. Let us look at the some interesting species on the earth biodiversity, that is the currently available species inventories. More than 70% of all species recorded are animals, while plants comprise no more than 22% of the total. Okay, so total animals are present on this earth, variety of the animals 70%, plants 22%, and other organisms, that is the other parts, 8%. That is the animals. Among animals, insects are the most species-rich taxonomic group, making up more than 70% of the total. That means out of every 10 animals on the plants, 7 are insects. Okay, so insects, arthropods are the big animals. Okay, arthropods are present in the large number comparison to the other parts. So insects, if 10 species are present on a part, 7 are insects. Okay. The number of the fungi species is what is more than combined total the species, fishes, amphibians, reptiles and mammals. Biodiversity is depicted showing the species number in the major taxa. It should be noted that these estimated do not give any figures for the prokaryotes. Biologists are not sure about how many prokaryotic species are there might be. The problem is that conventional taxonomic methods are not suitable for identifying microbial species. Many species are simply not cultured under the laboratory conditions. If we accept biochemical or molecular criteria for declining the species for this group, their diversity also runs into the millions. Okay, if you properly count them, they can more than millions. Okay, although India has 24% of the world's most lands area, they share the global species diversity about 8.1%. That is the make our country more than 112 mega diversity countries of the world. Nearly 45,000 pieces of plants and twice as many animals have been recorded from India. How many living species are actually there waiting to be discovered or named? If we accept May's global estimates, only 22% of total species have been recorded so far. Applying this proportion, 1 lakh plant species, more than 3 lakh animal species yet to be discovered and described. So more than 1 plant species, 1 lakh, and more than 3 lakhs. Okay. And consider the immense trained manpower and the time required to complete the job. The situation appears more than hopeless when we realize that a release function that species faces the threat of the becoming extinct even before we discover them. Nature's biological library is burning even before we calculate the titles of books stock there. Patterns of biodiversity, longitudinal gradients. Species area relationship, the importance of the species diversity of the ecosystem. Longitudinal, latitudinal gradients, the diversity of plants and animals is not uniform throughout the world but shows a rather uneven distribution. Obviously, it is not possible that all the animals are always same in number. Natality, mortality, giving birth of new animals, death of animals, that's continuous. And they can distributed in different area. So all time the same number pieces present in the same area, that is also not possible. So for many group of animals and plants, there are interesting patterns in diversity, the most well known being latitudinal gradients in the diversity. In general, species diversity decreases as more away from the equator and latitudinal gradients in diversity, species diversity decrease as we move away from the equator towards the poles. With very few exceptions, tropics range harbor more species than the temperate to polar areas. Colombia, located near the equator, always nearly 14,000 species of birds, while New York at 41 degree N has 105 species and Greenland at 71.N only 56 species India. More than land area in the tropical, this is not more important, just read that chapter thoroughly. 1,200 pieces of the birds, for a different region contains different numbers of the species, basically. A forest in a tropical region equator up to 10 times as many species of vascular plants as a forest of equal area in a temperate region like Midwest of the USA. The largely tropical Amazonian rainforest in South America has greatest biodiversity on Earth. It is home to more America has greatest biodiversity, more than 40,000 species of plants, 3,000 of fishes, 1,300 of birds, 427 of mammals, 427 of amphibians, 378 of reptiles, and more than 125,000 invertebrates. So invertebrates are large in number. Scientists estimate that in this rainforest there might be at least 2 million insect species waiting to be discovered and named. What is so special about tropics that might be account for their greater biological diversity? Ecologists and evolutionary biologists have proposed various hypotheses. Some important ones are: speciation is generally a function of time. Unlike temperate regions subjected to frequent glaciations in the past, tropical latitude have remained relatively undistributed for millions of years and thus had a long evolutionary time for the species diversity. Tropical environments, unlike temperate one, less seasonal, relatively more than constant predictable, and lead to the greater species diversity. There is more solar energy available in the tropics, which contributes to the higher productivity. This turn might contribute indirectly to the greater diversity. Okay, so next day we will continue the species area relationship. This is up to for the today. Bye bye everyone.